Good evening, everyone. Atlantic Broadband Cable, in cooperation with the South Union Township Supervisors, presents the South Union Township Sports Network. Tonight, by a tape delay from the Harold Horst Taylor Memorial Gymnasium, it's the Laurel Highlands Girls Basketball Phillies hosting the Oakland Catholic Eagles. Hello, everyone. This is Gary Frankhauser on the play-by-play. Jerry Dupay on the camera. We welcome you aboard once again for tonight's basketball action. The South Union Township Sports Network coverage is brought to you as a joint cooperative venture featuring the supervisors of South Union, Bob Schiffbeyer, Rick Vernon, and Jason Scott, Atlantic Broadband Cable, Armstrong Cable, and CUTV with Gary Smith. You can also watch these games on YouTube. Just go to South Union Television on YouTube. Once again, Gary Frankhauser along with Jerry Dupay. Let's take a look at the starting lineup first for the visiting Oakland Catholic Eagles. Starting at one of the guards, number 2, Jade Boyd. She's a senior. Number 10, Alexis Sestrick. She's also a senior. Number 12, Claire Paluski, a senior. Number 24, Margaret Terry, a junior. And number 41, Sierra D'Angelo, a senior. Four seniors and a junior in that starting lineup for Oakland Catholic. We'll be back with the starting lineup for the homestanding Laurel Highlands Phillies right after this. You're watching the South Union Township Sports Network.
Centers for Rehab Services, CRS, a part of UPMC and the Center for Sports Medicine, is a proud sponsor of the South Union Township Sports Network and its coverage of area youth sports. Make Centers for Rehab Services your choice for all of your physical and occupational therapy needs. CRS, located at 160 Wayland Smith Drive, provides physical therapy, occupational therapy, work injury programs, and hand therapy. Valuing patient satisfaction is one of their highest priorities. Centers for Rehab Services offers a patient-centered environment where each patient has an individualized treatment plan developed for their specific needs. They are experts in helping you recover from injuries, increase strength, and build endurance. CRS professionals have become highly skilled through a strong commitment to continuing education and advanced certifications to ensure the most cutting-edge and cost-effective treatment for their patients. Jim Burns, a lifetime Uniontown area resident, is a licensed physical therapist and facility director of the Uniontown location, as well as a field faculty instructor for Duquesne University and for the University of Pittsburgh School of Physical Therapy. He invites you to stop by his state-of-the-art location and discuss your rehabilitation needs. Center for Rehab Services is participating with most insurance plans, including all Highmark products, UPMC Health Plan, and Medicare. Available 5 days a week and offering extended hours for patient convenience, patients are seen within 24 to 48 hours and walk-ins are always welcome. Patients may also be seen through direct access, which does not require a physician's prescription. CRS worked with physicians and other healthcare providers to help you find relief, live your life again, and get you back into the game. For more information, call CRS at 724-437-7500. Where you treat for physical therapy is always your choice, so ask for Centers for Rehab Services. It's your health, it's your choice.
Many people unknowingly have chronic liver disease and discover it during routine blood testing. Possible causes include alcohol, hepatitis C, fatty liver, and iron overload. If left unchecked, this can lead to cirrhosis or severe liver scar. Offer the latest testing and treatment for chronic liver disease. SWGI, specialists in digestive health.
Davis & Davis, attorneys at law.
Every person who's been injured, when they come in, has an expectation that their case is important, and it is to us. We take these cases very seriously.
So that experience that we have is unique also because we have experience in these communities, in Uniontown, in Washington, in Waynesburg, in these court systems.
You don't have to go to Pittsburgh to be represented by attorneys who don't know their way around your community.
Davis and Davis, attorneys at law.
Here we go with the starters for Laurel Highlands coming into tonight's action, looking for their first section victory under the coaching of Rebecca Capoza. The starters, number 3, Taylor Smith, a 5'8" junior guard. Number 12, Taylor Engel, 5'9" senior forward. Number 13, Lori Miller, 5'3" junior guard. Number 15, Angel Bawawa, 5'11" senior center. And number 32, Ariana Griffith, 5'6" freshman guard. We'll be back with the national anthem, PA announcements by Barry Rosner, and the opening tip right after this on the South Union Township Sports Network.
Turn to the experts. Fayette Furnace Company Incorporated, serving the Tri-County area since 1920, the area's oldest and most reliable heating and cooling contractor, specializing in Carrier equipment. Employee owned and operated, choosing Fayette Furnace Company and Carrier not only gives you over 200 years of experience, but gives you the experts to help you solve your home's comfort needs. And call Fayette Furnace Company and Carrier to solve your home comfort needs today. Call 724-438-5400 or look up Fayette Furnace Company on the web at fayettefurnacecompany.com. Turn to the experts, almost 100 years of serving the Tri-County area. For more information, call Mike at 724-438-5400. That's 724-438-5400 for Fayette Furnace Company.
Creditors calling you day and night? Your debt overwhelms you? Although you may feel that you're in a hopeless situation, Zebley Mahalov & White can help. We're a full-service local bankruptcy firm that knows what a difficult time this is and what to do to help you get a fresh start. Call Zebley Mahalov & White today for a free consultation. Your hometown bankruptcy firm. Call us today.
Don't borrow more money until you talk to Zebley Mahalov & White.
Welcome back to the Laurel Highlands High School Harold Horse Taylor Memorial Gymnasium. We're just about ready for high school girls basketball action. Before we do that, we're going to stand and hear the national anthem.
Hey, good evening, everyone. Welcome to the campus of Laurel Highlands Senior High School and the Harold Horse Taylor Memorial Gymnasium. Tonight's girls' section basketball action as the Phillies of Laurel Highlands is hosting the Eagles from Oakland Catholic. Before we get started, ladies and gentlemen, we ask if you would to please rise. And gentlemen, we ask if you would to please remove your hats in the honor of America at the playing of our national anthem.
Barry.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the
National Anthem. We will have the introduction of the starting lineups once again by PA announcer Barry Rosner. Officials for tonight's game, Alex Speck, Joseph Parton, and Jay Peoples. Here's the Oakland Catholic Eagles. Brianne O'Rourke coaching Oakland Catholic, coming in 4-0 in section, 9-1 overall, ranked very high in the WPIL. Number two, Jade Boyd, she's a senior. Number 10, Alexis Sestrich, also a senior. Kara Paluski, also a senior, four seniors and a junior in the starting lineup for Oakland Catholic. Sierra D'Angelo, also a senior. Margaret Terry, a junior. There's your starters for Oakland Catholic. Now for the homestanding, Laurel Highlands Phillies.
A senior, number 12, Taylor Engel.
Taylor Engel, senior forward, 5'9".
A senior, number 15, Angel Bawawa.
Angel Bawawa, also a senior, 5'11".
A freshman, number 32, Ariana Griffith.
Number 32, Ariana Griffith. 5'6" freshman, seeing a lot of action here for the Laurel Highlands Phillies.
Lori Miller,
5'3" junior guard, rounding out that starting lineup. Taylor Smith, having an outstanding junior campaign for the Laurel Highlands Phillies. Here we go, ready for the opening tip. Laurel Highlands in the homestanding white Oakland Catholic, the traveling black uniforms. Laurel Highlands will be attacking our basket to the right as we start the first half, and Oakland Catholic will head toward the basket on the left. Look for Oakland Catholic to apply a lot of pressure. Always a solid program down there at Oakland Catholic. Home of Dan Marino, I believe. Central Catholic. I'm sorry, I got them mixed up. That's right. Central's boys, Oakland's girls. That's right. So it's pretty much the same place. Here we go. Ready for action. Jumping center, Ariana Griffith. No, I'm sorry, that's Angel Bawawa, number 15. Controlled by the Phillies. That's Taylor Smith. She'll do the bulk of the ball handling. Take it to the hoop right away. Up and no good. Rebound put back. No good by Buwawa. Saved in bounds. And here comes Oakland Catholic. Number 12 is Claire Paluski handling the ball out front. Margaret Terry. 2-3 zone for the Phillies. Pack it back in. Make sure to limit those inside shots. But three on the way. Blocked that time. Alexis Sestrick trying the three from the far corner. Blocked by Buwawa. Nice defense there. Far out into the corner. Taking the ball out of bounds. Number 24, Margaret Terry. Make sure they have this spot correct as the ball went out of bounds on the sideline. Trigger it in there to Claire Paluski. She'll hand it back to Terry. Terry now on top to Boyd. Number two, Boyd. She'll try the three. Got it. No hesitation there as Jade Boyd puts up the three and connects. First points of the ball game at the 7:05 mark. Pass ahead a little too far that time for number 32, Ariana Griffith. Phillies back on defense. We'll try to put a little full court pressure on. Have a player deep for Oakland Catholic. They found her deep, and that's going to be a score. Easy bucket for Sierra D'Angelo. 5-0 now. Taylor able to re-grab that one. Unable to make the catch again there. Ariana Griffith. Got to secure those passes. Wide open in the corner. Had the opportunity for a jumper, I would think. With the left, score it. Alexis Sestrick for two. So Oakland Catholic runs out now to a 7-0 lead and knocks that one out of bounds. Substitutions quickly in now for the Phillies. That's going to be, let's see who's coming in, number 30. That's Journey Greer. And number 4, Malaya Rafel. Taylor gets it deep in the corner to Buwawa. Swing it back out now. Miller hands to Taylor. Corner to Buwawa. Motion offense for the Phillies against the man-to-man defense. Taylor takes it in. A lot of hands up on that. Knock it out of bounds. In the tall trees there, Taylor Smith really not an easy opportunity at the hoop. Stolen away. Jade Boyd now gets it out quickly, and Oakland Catholic right to the hoop and scored again. Got to step in front of that on defense. Scoring that one, Margaret Terry. Scoring spread out among four Oakland Catholic Eagles so far. Knocked out of bounds, and it will stay with the Phillies. Phillies need to stem the tide here a little bit, get on the board. Strong man-to-man defense. Screen out on top. Buwawa looking. Taylor Smith. She'll try to take it herself. She does. Score it, Taylor. High off the glass. Once again, the Phillies leave the deep pass wide open, and Sierra D'Angelo with the easy bucket. Lori Miller gets it back to Taylor. Now to Lori. Gets it inside, but fronting that and defending that was D'Angelo. The breakout again. Good stop by Jade Boyd, and she'll score the bucket, making it 13-2. Timeout called by the Phillies. We'll step aside, be back on the other side of these messages on the South Union Township Sports Network. 13-2, Oakland Catholic on top.
At what point did everything change? When did service get taken out of service industries? It's too bad, because people are busy these days, at life, at work, at play. When it comes to your hard-earned money, you want service, real service, from a person you know and a face you trust. At a bank where changing with the times doesn't mean leaving people behind. We're proud to be a part of your community. We're United Bank, at your service.
Here we go, out of the timeout. Laurel Highlands will have it for the full court press again by Oakland Catholic. Taylor needs to get it in the middle. She does. Angle with the catch. Could have been a double dribble there. Looked like a pass that Taylor was trying to off the rim. Back comes Oakland Catholic. On top, handling the ball, junior Margaret Terry. Three on the way, off the back of the iron, no good. Offensive rebound, it's going to be a foul called. In there on the boards, Alexis Sestrick on the long rebound. Foul called on number four. Drive in the middle, three on the way again, and Jade Boyd looks like she has the free rein to let him fly from three-point range. That foul was on Rafel, her first team first. Double team on the side. Taylor will reset. She's going to send a man through. Try the three, short. Quickly back come the Eagles. That's a good defense there by Taylor Smith. To the hoop. That's going to be a blocking, a charge. Wow. Not sure about that one. Kind of sidestepped, but they called the offensive foul there on Lori Miller as she tried to get to the hoop. That's going to be her first, team second. Spin move inside by D'Angelo, and now we have another call on the Phillies. Two-shot foul this time. That's going to be on number 30. Journey, her first. So three Phillies with fouls and three team fouls. Hitting the first foul shot is Alexis Sestrick, I should say. Substitution back in the game for Laurel Highlands as Alexis hits them both. 3:37 to go here in the first, 18-2. Oakland Catholic quick out to the 16-point lead. And there's a steal, throw it back in. That's going to be controlled by the Phillies. Throw it back in. Jade Boyd looks very athletic. Kick it out to the 20-foot jumper, no good. Rebound over the top that time by Margaret Terry. Three on the way again. Offensive battle for the rebound. Up and in by Sierra D'Angelo. She has six first quarter points. Taylor being harassed by everyone. She's going to take the foul. There's a contact on the side that time by Margaret Terry, and that's going to send Taylor Smith to the line. Margaret Terry picks up for her first, team first. Taylor with the only two for the Phillies so far here in the first quarter. Rims out the first one. Substitution in for Oakland Catholic, number 32, Jordan Angelito. Taylor with her second opportunity. In and out. Wow. This is Terry. She just gets it inside. Nice ball fake, and with the left, unable to complete that was D'Angelo. Phillies with the rebound. Corner pass now. This is Griffith. Over to Taylor. She'll take the three. High off the rim. No good. Good hustle inside. That's going to be off of number 32, Ariana Griffith, but good attempt at that offensive rebound. .220 to go here in the first. On the side there, Jordan Angelito. Back inside to D'Angelo. Three on the way, rolls out. D'Angelo strong on the board. She'll kick it out again. Terry with the three, nothing on that one. It's going to be saved in again to Oakland Catholic. From the elbow this time, third opportunity. It's going to be out of bounds. Back to Oakland Catholic. Taylor just could not pull that one in. Out of bounds underneath to Oakland Catholic. Good cut there by D'Angelo, and she'll score her eighth point of the quarter. Just a cross there in the lane, creating the diversion and allowing D'Angelo to come free. It's going to be a foul called here. Foul called on number 10, Alexis Sestrick. That's her first team foul, number two. Keep the possession with the Phillies, trailing 22-2. Minute 40 to go here in the first. Taylor has it stolen away. Could be a travel. Went to the floor, but no call. Terry, long three on the way. Ain't got it. I'm sorry, that's number 32. Jordan Angelito with the three. Quality squad here, Oakland Catholic. Terry with the steal. She'll score. Nobody in the middle for the Phillies. Need somebody to cut to the ball there in the middle. Just throw it down the sideline. It's not going to work. D'Angelo to the hoop. Can't get it to go. Fight for the rebound. It's going to be a jump ball call. With 50 seconds to go, it'll be Oakland Catholic with the inbounds underneath. D'Angelo will swing it around. They'll get the pick in the corner. Three on the way. Good one. That's Alexis Sestrick. They all can fire them from deep range. They're not shy about it either. .32 seconds to go. Taylor with the only two for the Phillies. To the hoop now, up and trying to get one to the hoop that time was Lori Miller. She's fouled and will go to the line 4-2. That's on D'Angelo, her first team foul, number three. And Lori will have a couple opportunities here from the free line, free throw line, I should say. This is the first. One more for Lori. Got it. 30-3, 24 seconds to go. 1-2-2 zone now for the Phillies. Trying to switch it up. Three on the way again, and it will count one more time. Alexis Sestrick cans it. She has two threes, a deuce, and two for two from the line. 10 points in the quarter. It's going to be an offensive foul called on Taylor. Trying to create some space. That's going to be her first. With 1.8 seconds to go, and already a 30-point advantage for Oakland Catholic. As the first quarter ends, we'll be back with second quarter action right here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
Centers for Rehab Services, CRS, a part of UPMC and the Center for Sports Medicine, is a proud sponsor of the South Union Township Sports Network and its coverage of area youth sports. Make Centers for Rehab Services your choice for all of your physical and occupational therapy needs. CRS, located at 160 Wayland Smith Drive, provides physical therapy, occupational therapy, work injury programs, and hand therapy. Valuing patient satisfaction is one of their highest priorities. Centers for Rehab Services offers a patient-centered environment where each patient has an individualized treatment plan developed for their specific needs. They are experts in helping you recover from injuries, increase strength, and build endurance. CRS professionals have become highly skilled through a strong commitment to continuing education and advanced certifications to ensure the most cutting-edge and cost-effective treatment for their patients. Jim Burns, a lifetime Uniontown area resident, is a licensed physical therapist and facility director of the Uniontown location, as well as a field faculty instructor for Duquesne University and for the University of Pittsburgh School of Physical Therapy. He invites you to stop by his state-of-the-art location and discuss your rehabilitation needs. Center for Rehab Services is participating with most insurance plans, including all Highmark products, UPMC Health Plan, and Medicare. Available 5 days a week and offering extended hours for patient convenience, patients are seen within 24 to 48 hours and walk-ins are always welcome. Patients may also be seen through direct access, which does not require a physician's prescription. CRS worked with physicians and other healthcare providers to help you find relief, live your life again, and get you back into the game. For more information, call CRS at 724-437-7500. Where you treat for physical therapy is always your choice, so ask for Centers for Rehab Services. It's your health, it's your choice.
Cancer is the second leading cause of cancer deaths. Signs include abdominal pain and rectal bleeding. Colon cancer develops from a degenerating benign growth or polyp. Doctors performing colonoscopy are able to remove precancerous polyps, thus preventing colon cancer. This saves lives, and the American Cancer Society now recommends that everyone have a colonoscopy every 10 years, beginning at age 50. Offer the latest diagnostic testing. SWGI, specialists in digestive health.
Davis and Davis, attorneys at law.
Important for people to know that we represent injured people to the best of our ability, and we've been successful doing that. And I don't say that to have people come to see us because we have been successful. I say that because it's true. And it's important.
Another important aspect is the experience that we have is local experience, experience in the court system in Uniontown, in Washington, in Waynesburg.
Davis and Davis, attorneys at law.
Welcome back. We're ready for second quarter action. Certainly can see why the Oakland Catholic Eagles are very highly rated here in the WPIAL, as it will be the Phillies inbound across the way. A couple substitutions in for Oakland Catholic. We'll try to get those for you as we go along. I see number 14, Alyssa Morgan in there, sophomore. Taylor in the corner there to Griffith. Left-hand dribble out on top there. That's Greer. Lori Miller holds it high. A cross-court pass is going to be a problem against this Oakland Catholic defense. To the hoop. Nice sidestep and score for Alexis Sestrick. She has 12 already here in the first half. Man-to-man defense all the time for Oakland. All kind of contact, nothing called there. To the hoop and score it once again. This time it was number 24, Margaret Terry, for the bucket. Taylor looking for some help. Lori with the cut across. She'll take a three. Off the rim, no good. Gets her own rebound. Long rebound. Hands it to Greer in the corner, and that's off the hands and out of bounds to Oakland Catholic. Back into the game now for Oakland Catholic. Number two, Jade Boyd, as well as number 12, Claire Paluski. Got to get him there playing time. Pass across there. That's number 21, Mia Viglotti, who just came in. Good pass out to the side and bucket by number 14, Alyssa Morgan. They can all put it in the hoop, no doubt about it. Taylor looking for some help. Good move to the hoop, runner. Rolls around, can't get it to go. Quickly out, stolen there by Greer, tries to get it back inside. All kind of hands in there on that one. Way out on top now to Lori Miller. Lori in the corner, posting up is Buwawa. Up and got it. Nice baseline roller there by Angel Buwawa. Give her two and she'll go to the line for a foul shot. Fouls on number 12, Claire Paluski, her first, team foul number four. Checking back in for the Phillies, number 12, Taylor Engel. Shot on the way and a lane violation. So no shot. Lane violation by the Phillies. Checking in now, number two, Zyteria Collins. Here comes Jade Boyd. Gets it in the corner, and they'll let it fly. That's a good hoop. Wow. For 32, Jordan Angelito with the three-pointer and the foul. Foul's on number two, Zyteria Collins, who just came in. Three-pointer and the foul. No iron on that one, so that will be out of bounds to the Phillies. Oakland Catholic now drops back into a 2-3 zone. Motion offense, got to be careful with those passes. Very active, no matter what defense they're in, Oakland Catholic. Hand off now. They're going to try to weave it out front. Angle, skip pass across to Taylor. She takes a long three and cans it. Taylor Smith with the three. 42 to 8. Didn't count that three. Baseline, little travel. Too many steps that time. Jordan Angelito unable to put the ball down before the feet moved. The Phillies with the opportunity now with 5:04 to go here in the second quarter. Good pass in, shot and score it. Nice offensive play that time. Number 32, Ariana Griffith with the bucket. Foul's going to be on Morgan, her first. Team foul number five. Ariana Griffith trying to complete the three-point play. She does. So the Phillies with 11 now, 42-11. Docked away and stolen. This is Taylor. Quickly back. She'll stop and shoot. Got it. Taylor Smith with seven. Jade Boyd trying to overload that right side. They will take the three at all times. That's up off the top, and that may not come down. It does. Hit the stanchion on top. That's automatically out of bounds. Good eye by the outside official. Did see that touch the support system, which makes it out of bounds. We're going to swing it around now, try to get somebody open for a jump. That same play, but this time blocked by number 41. Taylor with the shot. Rebound inside by Taylor Engel, and she's going to go to the line 4-2. That's on Claire Paluski, her second. Sierra D'Angelo back in the game, number 41 for Oakland Catholic. Taylor Engel in and out. Second one on the way, rims out again. Jade calling the play out top for Oakland Catholic. They'll swing it around the perimeter and look for that three-pointer. Baseline runner, nice block there. Good defense on the baseline by Angel Buwawa, denying that opportunity at the hoop. Same play inside. Phillies decipher that now. Boyd for the three. No good. Rebound pulled down on the weak side there by number 32, Angelito. Good ball movement there by Oakland Catholic. D'Angelo will stop and take the foul line jumper and hits it. Gets her into double figures at 10. Phillies now facing the man-to-man defense again as Oakland Catholic switches up. That's going to be a hand check called. That's going to be a bonus foul shot now for the Phillies. Fouls on number 14. That's her second, team foul number 7. So 1-1 for Ariana Griffith, checking back in the game. Three-point specialist, Alexis Sestrick. Off the rim, no good. Sestrick quickly back. Boyd for the three. Short off the rim, good box out, but the rebound right to Alexis Sestrick. Puts it back in, she has 14. Taylor looking for some room. And that's going to be a body foul there on Jade Boyd. Good drive to the hoop that time by Taylor Smith. Crossover dribble. Got ahead of the defender. Used it to her advantage to get to the hoop. That's the first foul on Jade Boyd. Taylor 0 for 2 at the line. Hits this one. Second one, just a little bit short. Jay just saw the opening. She'll take the three and hit it. Can't leave her open. Gives her 11 for the first half. 2:25 to go here in the second quarter. 49-14, there's another steal. That's going to be a travel. Jade knew what she wanted to do. Stopped there at about 5 feet inside the foul line. Had the pass off to her right, but took too many steps. Taylor trying to create some room. Gets a screen, takes a long three. No good. Good box out there by the Eagles. coming out of there quickly with the rebound. Trying to go baseline. She does, gets her own rebound. That's Jade Boyd. Kick it back out. Sestrick with the jumper, too strong. Get it to Lori in the corner. She takes to the hoop, can't get it up, but she's going to be fouled. That's going to be on number 12, I believe. That is Alyssa Morgan, her third personal. And to the line will be Lori Miller. Lori with her first points of the evening. Checking in, number 45, that's Anna Sproul. Taylor, no. Lori, no good on the second. Three-pointer up and in for number 32, Jordan Angelito. That's her third three already here in the first half. We're down to a minute, 5 seconds to go here in the second. There's all kind of contact, and wow, we got an illegal screen, I believe. That's on Taylor Engel, just did not establish good position there for the screen. Player control foul counts toward the total. That's the fifth team foul on Laurel Highlands. Perimeter ball movement excellent by Oakland Catholic. It's another travel there by Boyd. Thought about the short jumper on the baseline when she took that move to drive to the hoop. Too many steps. 52 seconds to go. Half court man-to-man defense by Oakland Catholic. Good pick and roll there, but Bawawa could not hold on to the ball. Nice fundamentals on the offensive play. D'Angelo with the pump fake and score it. 12 for D'Angelo. Taylor Smith couldn't get it to go. 19 seconds to go. One more point and it'll be a mercy roll for the second half, and that is it. Jade Boyd with the bucket. 56-15. Have the alternate timing for the second half. Unless Laurel Highlands can score here. They do. And that's going to be a good bucket by Taylor Smith to make our halftime score. Oakland Catholic 56, Laurel Highlands 17. We'll be back with halftime statistics and more here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
Turn to the experts. Fayette Furnace Company Incorporated, serving the Tri-County area since 1920, the area's oldest and most reliable heating and cooling contractor, specializing in Carrier equipment. Employee owned and operated, choosing Fayette Furnace Company and Carrier not only gives you over 200 years of experience, but gives you the experts to help you solve your home's comfort needs. Call Fayette Furnace Company and Carrier to solve your home comfort needs today. Call 724-438-5400 or look up Fayette Furnace Company on the web at fayettefurnacecompany.com. Turn to the experts, almost 100 years of serving the Tri-County area. For more information, call Mike at 724-438-5400. That's 724-438-5400 for Fayette Furnace Company.
Welcome back to the Harold Horst Taylor Memorial Gymnasium. Impressive showing by Oakland Catholic in the first half. And the Phillies will have a tall order to try to get back into the game, work on some fundamentals, and move forward in the section action. For Oakland Catholic, 56 points in the first half. 13 points by Jade Boyd. She had 3 3-pointers and 2 2-pointers. 14 points by Alexis Sestrick. She had 2 3-pointers, 3 2-pointers, and 2 for 2 from the line. Alyssa Morgan came in off the bench for a bucket in the second quarter. Margaret Terry with 6 points, 4 in the first, 2 in the second, all 2-pointers. Jordan Angelito off the bench with 3 3-pointers for 9. Sierra D'Angelo dominating the inside with 8 points in the first quarter, 4 in the second for her total of 12 points. 33 in the first, 23 in the second for their total of 56. The Phillies just 3 in the first and 14 in the second for their total of 17 points. When we come back, we are going to have second half action here on the South Union Township Sports Network. It's the Laurel Highlands Phillies and the Oakland Catholic Eagles.
At what point did everything change? When did service get taken out of service industries? It's too bad, because people are busy these days, at life, at work, at play. When it comes to your hard-earned money, you want service, real service, from a person you know and a face you trust. At a bank where changing with the times doesn't mean leaving people behind. We're proud to be a part of your community. We're United Bank, at your service.
Centers for Rehab Services, CRS, a part of UPMC and the Center for Sports Medicine, is a proud sponsor of the South Union Township Sports Network in its coverage of area youth sports. Make Centers for Rehab Services your choice for all of your physical and occupational therapy needs. CRS, located at 160 Wayland Smith Drive, provides physical therapy, occupational therapy, work injury programs, and hand therapy. Valuing patient satisfaction is one of their highest priorities. Centers for Rehab Services offers a patient-centered environment where each patient has an individualized treatment plan developed for their specific needs. They are experts in helping you recover from injuries, increase strength, and build endurance. CRS professionals have become highly skilled through a strong commitment to continuing education and advanced certifications to ensure the most cutting-edge and cost-effective treatment for their patients. Jim Burns, a lifetime Uniontown area resident, is a licensed physical therapist and facility director of the Uniontown location, as well as a field faculty instructor for Duquesne University and for the University of Pittsburgh School of Physical Therapy. He invites you to stop by his state-of-the-art location and discuss your rehabilitation needs. Center for Rehab Services is participating with most insurance plans, including all Highmark products, UPMC Health Plan, and Medicare. Available 5 days a week and offering extended hours for patient convenience, patients are seen within 24 to 48 hours and walk-ins are always welcome. Patients may also be seen through direct access, which does not require a physician's prescription. CRS works with physicians and other healthcare providers to help you find relief, live your life again, and get you back into the game. For more information, call CRS at 724-437-7500. Where you treat for physical therapy is always your choice, so ask for Centers for Rehab Services. It's your health, it's your choice.
Welcome back to the Harold Horse Taylor Memorial Gymnasium. We're just about ready for second half action. It will be possession to Oakland Catholic, now going to the right basket. Phillies will be defending, trailing 56-17. Oakland Catholic will come out with number 10, Alexis Sestrick. Number 2, Jade Boyd. Number 24, Margaret Terry. Number 45, Anna Sproul. And if I can pick up that last number there, I believe that's Sierra D'Angelo. It is. And the Phillies, their same starting lineup. Taylor Smith, Taylor Engel, Lori Miller, Angel Bawawa, and Ariana Griffith. 1-2-2 defense now for Laurel Highlands. They'll just pass and screen away is the design for Oakland Catholic. Try to get it to the high post there to D'Angelo. She could turn and shoot that foul line jumper, but now in the corner it's Boyd for the three-pointer on the way, too strong. Good rebound there by Buwawa. Gets it across to Taylor Smith. Ahead now to Lori Miller. Back to Taylor. She'll stop and shoot. Off the rim, no good. Breakout now for Oakland Catholic. Score it for number 10, Alexis Sestrick, and that will move us into the alternate timing with a more than 40-point advantage here in high school basketball. Duwawa on top. Gets it to Lori Miller. Looks for help. Taylor on the drive. Good drive behind the back. Stop at the elbow. Won't go. Griffith tried to save it. I'm sorry, that was Buwawa. Boyd quickly back. Taylor reached in, could not defend that, and Jade Boyd scores. 6:30 on a running clock here at the Harold Horse Taylor Memorial Gymnasium. That's an illegal screen. Consistent call there, both sides. That will be on number 10, I believe. I'm sorry. Number 15. Bella Fabian, who just checked in, got the foul. At the elbow, she likes that shot. Rimmed it out, though, D'Angelo. Ahead now to Lori Miller. It's going to be a travel call on Oakland Catholic. I have to correct myself. That last call was on Laurel Highlands, number 15, Angel Bawawa. That was her first. Had my teams mixed up there. Now checking in, Claire Paluski for Oakland Catholic. Corner to Taylor. Nice catch there. Take it to the hoop with the left. Up, couldn't get it above the rim. Battle for the rebound. Taylor comes away with it, gets it inside off the hand of Taylor Engel, out of bounds. Jade Boyd now will handle the ball, bringing it up. On the left side, that's number 32, Jordan Angelito. D'Angelo with the score, her first two of the second half. Give her 14. Griffith, the freshman. Taylor Engel over to Taylor Smith. Try to double team. Jade Boyd now will be guarding Taylor. Just could not get that one. Timeout called before the shot. by Coach Capoza for Laurel Highlands Phillies. A full timeout at 4:05 to go. We'll take a full timeout here on the South Union Township Sports Network. 62-17, Oakland Catholic on top.
Southwestern Endoscopy Center is a state-licensed and Medicare-certified facility and emphasizes privacy, comfort, caring, and safety for colonoscopies and upper GI endoscopies. Painless procedures are done with twilight sedation given by a board-certified anesthesiologist. The center accepts most insurance plans and is staffed by Drs. Ruthart, Calabrese, Stokes, SWGI, specialists in digestive health.
Davis and Davis, helping the injured.
If you're injured in an accident, after you address the medical problems, you're going to be faced with numerous questions concerning who's going to pay your medical bills, your property damage, the wages that you might be losing if you can't go to work. These are things that you need counsel for.
That your income is protected, that your bills are paid, that your family's taken care of. We've been doing this since 1976. We've helped injured people. We can help you.
Davis and Davis, attorneys at law.
Timeout is finished. We are back. Phillies will have it across the way, out of bounds. .405 to go here in the third. Oakland Catholic staying with that man-to-man defense. Checking in was Journey Greer. She throws it away. Now stolen back by Bawawa. Tried to get it ahead to Angle. Going to be a jump ball, and that's going to be to Laurel Highlands. Good awareness that time by Angel Bawawa, but once she had it, tried to get it ahead for a quick hoop and resulted in the tie-up. So once again, Laurel Highlands will have it out of bounds across the way. Lori outside the three-point line. Puts it on the floor. Finds Taylor inside. Bawawa was open. Could not handle the pass. Taylor gets it to the hoop. It's going to be out of bounds. Back to Laurel Highlands. Knocked away there by the Oakland Catholic defense. Now checking in number 14, Alyssa Morgan. As well as number 24, Margaret Terry for Oakland Catholic. Also number 15, Bella Fabian, now in the game. Bawawa tried to get it back to Taylor Smith, but too hard. Out of bounds. Clock quickly moving here in the third. We're down to 2 minutes and 30 seconds. Skip pass, now baseline drive. Step back jumper, off the glass, no good, but out of bounds, off Laurel Highlands. Two Phillies there trying to corral that, just could not get the handle. So Teria Collins now in for the Phillies, number two. Good defense there. Now what do we got? I think we got a foul on Taylor Smith. Her second. Team foul number two. Three on the way. No good. Good box out, but a long rebound gets back to Oakland Catholic. Another three on the way. They all have the green light, I believe. And another turnover by the Phillies. At the table to check in, Mia Viglotti, number 21. Ball fake there by Terry. Down the lane, a runner won't go for number 32, Jordan Ingolito, but the foul is called there on number 12, Taylor Engel. Two-shot opportunity. Jordan 0 for 2 at the line. Checking out Claire Paluski for Oakland Catholic. Too strong on that one. Rebound pulled in by Collins, and she's fouled on the rebound there by number 14, Alyssa Morgan. I believe that's her third foul. Same man-to-man defense. Taylor to the hoop with the left. Got it. Taylor Smith, her first two of the second half, gives her 12. Right back quickly come the Eagles. Battle for the rebound. That's going to be a foul called on Oakland Catholic, number 24. That's Margaret Terry, her second. Team foul number two. Just 10 seconds on a running clock. Taylor will try to get one up here late. She does. And can't get it to go. So the Phillies with 2 points in the quarter. And for Oakland Catholic, just six. 62-19, our score after three. We'll be right back. Gary Frankhauser along with Jerry DuPay. You're watching the South Union Township Sports Network.
Turn to the experts. Fayette Furnace Company Incorporated, serving the Tri-County area since 1920, the area's oldest and most reliable heating and cooling contractor, specializing in Carrier equipment. Employee owned and operated, choosing Fayette Furnace Company and Carrier not only gives you over 200 years of experience, but gives you the experts to help you solve your home's comfort needs. And call Fayette Furnace Company and Carrier to solve your home comfort needs today. Call 724-438-5400 or look up Fayette Furnace Company on the web at fayettefurnacecompany.com. Turn to the experts, almost 100 years of serving the Tri-County area. For more information, call Mike at 724-438-5400. That's 724-438-5400 for Fayette Furnace Company.
Here we go, fourth quarter action. Oakland Catholic with the possession and the lead. Been in control throughout. That's number 24, Margaret Terry on top. She'll control, being harassed there by Taylor Smith. Left hand to the hoop, and there's a foul called. All the way in to the hoop, number 21, Mia Viglotti, and she's fouled on the way in. That's going to be on Ariana Griffith, just her first. Team towel number four for the second half. Mia Viglotti with her first point of the evening. Cans them both. Deep bench also for Oakland Catholic. They go easy 10 deep with quality athletes. Oh, in the corner there. Collins trying to find some help. Finally, just throws it into the middle. To the hoop again. Unable to finish that time was Biglotti, but scoring that time looked like number 14. Alyssa Morgan with two. Three on the way, short that time by Griffith. Fight on the ground there. It's going to be foul call. Foul called on number 21, Biglotti, her first. Team foul, number three. Checking in now for Laurel Highlands. Three on the way by Taylor. Couldn't get it to roll. Number four, Malia Rafel, checked in. And the runners keep coming for Oakland. Knocked away. Good hustle, both teams, but that will be Oakland Catholic out of bounds on the near sideline. Clock down to 6 minutes to go here in the fourth. Three on the way, and it's good for number 24, Margaret Terry. Five points in the quarter. Left-hand runner by Taylor couldn't get it to go. Got a travel call on that breakout. This is Lori Miller. She'll get her across to Griffith. It's almost stolen away again. Griffith with the drive. She'll stop and take the three. Off the rim, short. Fight for the rebound. Jump ball call. That's going to go back to Laurel Highlands. 69-19. Good pass inside, but could not be controlled by Griffith. Quickly back come the Eagles with the left. Can't get it to go. Put it up in and out. Terry now get it on top. Biglotti back out on top to Terry. Ooh, good pass inside. Can't get it to finish. Finally a bucket. And that is number 11. Lydia Vavro, who scores for Oakland Catholic. Out of bounds, back to Oakland Catholic. Getting a little ragged here late with a running clock. 3:20 to go here in the fourth quarter. Phillies will pick up man-to-man here late in the game. Checking in was jumper now for Oakland Catholic. Couldn't get it to go. Trying to pick up the numbers here. Number five, Chaylen Barden just checked in for the Phillies. 5'5" sophomore guard will get some action here late. 2:45 to go. Foul call there on number 14, Alyssa Morgan, her fourth team foul, number four here in the second half. And their team close to the bonus. That's going to be out of bounds back to Laurel Highlands. Hit about 4 feet in the lane there. Last one was an Oakland Catholic foot timeout called, 30-second timeout. gives us a chance to step aside here quickly. 71-19, 2:24 to go here in the fourth on the South Union Township Sports Network.
Just sit right down and you hear a tale of a fateful call. You better pay those bills right now or you'll take a mighty fall. He really didn't know what to do, so he turned to those who did. Zeppeli, Mahalovan White, your bankruptcy crew, your bankruptcy crew. So no matter how deep in debt you are, if your back's against the wall, Zeppeli, Mahalovan White, just give them.
Baseline inbounds for the Phillies, trying to get on the board here in the fourth quarter. Throw it way out, stolen there. And that's going to be a block call as Terry tried to go the hoop. Too much contact there by Taylor Smith. Picks up her third. And that's going to send number 24, Margaret Terry, to the line. She has nine. First attempt at the line here this evening. Smooth from the line. Second one on the way, rolls out. Taylor will take it to the hoop herself. Got it, and the foul. Taylor, bright spot for the Phillies, as usual. Gives her 14 on the evening. And we'll send her to the line with an opportunity for a three-point play. Finishes the three-point play. Quickly back comes Oakland Catholic. This time, number 32, Jordan Angelito. She'll just control it out front with a minute 49 to go. Picked up now by Taylor. She'll try to take it herself. That's got to be a charge, and it is. Good call by the official. Good defense that time by number 5, Jalen Barden. She just established her position early, took the charge. Clock stopped for an official timeout while they do a little housekeeping under the hoop. Minute 30 to go. Number 24 is Olivia Crossan, who came in. Going to be a hand check on the way in. Fouls on number 11, Lydia Vavro. And that's 1-1. Taylor Smith to the line. Taylor trying to add to her total of 15. Make it 16. Second one good also. 4 for 5 from the line for Taylor. That's going to be a foul on Taylor. That's her fourth with 52 seconds to go. Kind of an inconsequential call there. To the hoop. Score it. That was number 32, Angelito for 2. Out of bounds, back to Oakland Catholic with 20 seconds to go. Probably look for them to dribble it out here and just let it run out. Outside to Angelito. She'll just dribble it out with 5 seconds to go. 2-1, and that will do it. Our final from the Harold Horse Taylor Memorial Gymnasium, 74-24, Oakland Catholic on top of the Laurel Highlands Phillies. We'll be back with the final statistics after this last message on the South Union Township Sports Network.
Davis and Davis, helping the injured.
In any endeavor, experience is probably the most important factor, but it's got to be the right kind of experience. Experience in the community where the case is tried, where the jurors live, where the judges work. We've been doing this since 1976 at Davis and Davis. That's a long time.
Davis and Davis, attorneys at law.
Welcome back to the Harold Horse Taylor Memorial Gymnasium. Oakland Catholic comes in and shows why they're very highly ranked here in the WPIAL Section 5A. Oakland Catholic dominating from the get-go and final score 74-24. Here's your scores for Oakland Catholic. Jade Boyd, the senior, came in with 15 points. She had 3 three-pointers, 16 points for Alexis Sestrick. She had 2 three-pointers, 2 for 2 from the line. Lydia Vavro came in late with a bucket for 2. Alyssa Morgan with 4. Mia Viglotti, 2 for 2 from the line for 2. Margaret Terry, 10 points. Jordan Angelito with 11. And Sierra D'Angelo rounding out the scoring with 14 points. For Oakland Catholic, 33 in the first, 23 in the second, 6 in the third, 12 in the fourth, for their total of 74 points. For the Laurel Highlands Phillies, Lori Miller with 2 foul shots for her 2 points, Angel Pawawa with a bucket for 2, and Ariana Griffith with a bucket and 1 for 2 from the line for 3, and leading all scorers, Taylor Smith with 17 points. The Phillies, 3 in the first, 14 in the second, 2 in the third, 5 in the fourth for their total of 24 points. Oakland Catholic will be back on the road. I'm looking for the schedule here to see who they play next. They will play Penn Hills at home on the 10th, and Laurel Highlands will be at Preston, West Virginia, 2 days from now on the 9th. So that will do it here from the Laurel Highlands High School Gymnasium, the Harold Horse Taylor Gymnasium. And tonight's game was brought to you as a joint cooperative venture with the supervisors of South Union Township, Bob Schiffbauer, Rick Vernon, and Jason Scott, Atlantic Broadband Cable, Armstrong Cable, everyone at CUTV, Gary Smith and his staff. This has been Gary Frankhauser on the play-by-play, Jerry DuPay on the camera, another South Union Township Sports Network presentation. Our final once again, Oakland Catholic 74, Laurel Highlands 24. Good night, everyone.